The mana spreader is a device for transporting and extracting mana. Thus, it can extract mana from mana-generating flowers into a nearby mana pool. You can also use it to drain mana from your mana pool and send it somewhere else, which could be another mana pool. You will need living wood, gold ingot, and mystical white petal or white shimmering mushroom to craft mana spreader. Let's see how this device works. I'll show you an example where we extract mana from a flower and transport it to a nearby mana pool. First, we'll need a thing called the Wand of the Forest, which can detect the status of a certain device and control it. So we take it in our hand, and now we can see the path of the so-called mana burst, which will be fired from the mana spreader, shown in green. So this determines where the mana will be transported. The mana pool is for storing mana, so let's put it somewhere. Now the mana spreader will need to be correctly pointed at the mana pool. We will need the Wand of the Forest for this, and now we have two options. The easiest way is to switch your wand to bind mode. Wand modes are switched using the sneak key, which is usually shift. Then press the right button to switch the mode. However, you must not aim at anything. Now hold the sneak key and right-click on mana spread, and now do the same for mana pool. Now the mana spreader is ready. The second way to rotate mana spreader requires switching the Wand of the Forest to function mode. Now if you hold sneak and the right button on the mana spreader, your character will grab it by the backside and you can rotate it as you want. Now only the last thing is missing, and that is to provide mana generation using some generating flower and the subsequent extraction provided by the mana spreader. Endoflame is the ideal flower for the beginning of the game. We will place it near the mana spreader, where the maximum distance between them must not be greater than 5 blocks. You can check that you placed it correctly with the Wand of the Forest. If we put it by a block further, you can see that the flower is not attached. After attaching the flower to the mana spreader, you also need to be careful that if you decide to move the mana spreader, the flower will not be automatically attached to it again. For this case, you will need to use the Wand of the Forest and use bind mode to pair the two things. But now let's get back to the point. The Endoflame flower will need to be fueled in order to generate mana. You can use any of the common fuels that you use, for example, for furnaces. Then you need to throw it near the flower that will receive it, and as you can see, it will start to burn during mana production. Even the mana spreader started to behave differently. It now actively casts a mana burst towards the mana pool, which is slowly filling with mana. However, it has a tremendous capacity. It can hold 1,000,000 mana units, so you'll see its bar as if it's empty for now. Also, note that the mana spreader has its own internal buffer that is actively filled and emptied. You may have noticed this green dot at the end of the green burst path. This indicates the maximum limit to which mana will be supplied without losses. So if we place the mana pool beyond this limit, mana will be supplied, but not in full. The maximum distance for transport is 12 blocks. Also, you may have wondered if one mana spreader can extract mana from more than one flower, and yes, as you can see, you can have many attached to it. The last thing I'm going to show you is how to transport mana from one mana pool to another. In this case, the mana spreader must not be more than one block away from the mana pool from which it will draw mana. You will then connect it in the same way you already know. Thanks for watching. If the video helped you, give us a like and subscribe.